SeaEnergy is currently establishing an offshore energy business, which it says aims to provide a number of services to the expanding offshore wind industry, with the final adjustments now made in the sale that SeaEnergy made last year of SeaEnergy Renewables to Repsol and EDPR, for which it gained almost £39 million. It's now moving forward with cash on the balance sheet, with a strategy that it broadly outlined last year. John Aldersey-Williams is the CEO and joins us now on the phone after the recent AGM. John, good to talk to you.
Hello, Jeremy.
Talk to us a little bit about what the message was at the annual general meeting.
Certainly. What we were trying to do at the annual general meeting just yesterday was to explain to shareholders how the vision that we set out for the business in the annual report in both 2012 and 2013 and the strategy we've been following since the beginning of 2012 when we refocused the business tie together and make an integrated picture that knits together what might look like slightly disparate businesses into a whole that's greater than the sum of the parts.
So where do you move then from here? As I said, you've got that strategy at the back end of last year. You've got this money on the balance sheet. Where do you move forward from this point?
Well, we're moving forward on a number of fronts. And as I say, the three core chunks of the business, and you'll see the AGM presentation describes these, our marine business, where we've been working to get purpose-built vessels in support of offshore wind activities into the market, and we're actively tendering those. In a consulting business, where we're building a consulting practice that has a strategic level of consulting advice to clients across the energy space and benefits from the knowledge and experience gained by the marine side. And then the third leg is the acquisition we made last year of a business called R2S, which has a fantastic product called Visual Asset Management, which is a visual front end for asset management databases, which sounds terribly technical until you realize it's a bit like Google Street View, but for oil and gas platforms or offshore wind installations, but with the added value that you can attach all of the information relating to an asset to the picture of the asset. So it's very easy to find and manage that information.
Mm. You've got this cash on the balance sheet, as I said, $39 million, I know, from the sale of this business. What are you going to do with that? What's it enabling you to do?
Okay, following the disposal of the SeaEnergy Renewables business, we decided that it was the right thing to do to return some of that cash to shareholders. So we returned £7 million of that cash in a tender offer during the course of 2012. We also, in 2012, spent some of that money on the R2S acquisition. And there were some other fees and repayments of debts involved with the SeaEnergy Renewables deal closing out. So at the end of 2012, we had just over £5 million of cash on the balance sheet.
The other aspect of the business I want to talk about, which is an interesting point to be made here, is that you still have this 21% stake in Lansdowne Oil and Gas. If looking down some of the notes that we've seen through brokers, Edison, the research house, says that a 10p move in the shares of Lansdowne will have a 5p effect on the SeaEnergy share price. Is it your intention to stick with the Lansdowne investment, or will you make another sale?
What we've said in all of our public statements is that the Lansdowne asset, and in fact we have one or two other small royalty interests in the oil and gas space, are very much considered to be legacy assets. And it's our intention, in an orderly way and over time, to exit those assets and to return a proportion of the gains realized to shareholders and use the rest to fund the refocusing of the business into the energy services space.
Well, finally as well, if I can return to the Edison note, it also says that with forecasted revenues of £4.2 million from R2S, the investment you were talking about that the company's made, SeaEnergy, it says, should break even this year. Where do you see the company moving from this point after that break-even point? And what are you going to be doing? What milestones should we be watching out for as investors?
The strategy has been to build a business with complementary streams of revenue and complementary activities. So R2S, the acquisition we made last year, came with revenues immediately, and what we've been seeing is those revenues have been growing steeply as we'd planned and expected, and that enabled us to pay the first deferred consideration payment to the vendors of that business earlier this year. So we expect to see continuing growth in R2S. So milestones to look out for in R2S are the announcement of further contracts with blue chip international oil companies, and you should be seeing more of those coming down the road as that business gets further across that business, both in terms of clients and in terms of geography. On the consulting side, you'll see Further announcements of consulting work, contracts we're winning on that part of the business, and also you're going to be seeing some job ads coming out. So we're going to be recruiting in the consulting space. And then finally, on the marine side, we're actively tendering those activities, and we'd hope to be announcing successful tenders for new build ships that are a longer-term part of the revenue picture but contribute to the longer-term and strong growth of the business over time. So there's lots of growth to look forward to, both in the near-term and the medium-term, coming from across the business.
Okay, John, well, it's a pleasure talking to you, and it's nice to be able to see a business that's growing in these times.
Thank you.
Okay, that's John Aldersey-Williams. He's the CEO of SeaEnergy.